This is Sarah Wilkinson from Humber College and the University of Guelph Humber. And in this new series of videos on key cardiovascular variables, I'm going to be giving a definition of cardiac output, stroke volume, and heart rate. In the next set of videos, I'll cover the regulation of heart rate, and then I'll be discussing factors that affect stroke volume. These are preload, contractility, and afterload. So let's get started on our basic definitions of these three variables. Let's start with cardiac output. We can think about cardiac output as the total volume of blood being pumped from the heart ventricle in 1 minute. So if we look down here, this is our left ventricle, and the cardiac output will be how much blood leaves this ventricle every minute. So we can think about cardiac output as the speed of blood flow through the body. And at rest, an average resting cardiac output is about 5 liters per minute. Smaller people will have a lower cardiac output, and larger people will have a larger cardiac output. During maximal exercise, cardiac output will be 4 to 7 times higher than rest. So in an untrained individual, we'll see it between 18 to 20 liters per minute, and in some of our elite endurance athletes, it will be much, much higher. Cardiac output will equal stroke volume times heart rate. We'll start out by discussing what heart rate is, followed by stroke volume. So we've all experienced taking our heart rate, and there's a number of different ways we can do this. We can do it by wearing a Polar watch or by manually palpating an artery. Essentially, what heart rate is counting the number of times the heart pumps in 1 minute. As you can see here, the heart is contracting a particular number of times per minute. And this can be sped up or slowed down. And an average resting heart rate ranges between 60 to 100 beats per minute. A lower resting heart rate can indicate a higher cardiovascular fitness. So coming back to our cardiac output, it's equal to stroke volume times heart rate. Let's have a look at the second variable that determines cardiac output. So we can think about stroke volume as the volume of blood ejected from the heart with each beat. The arrows depict here the amount of blood leaving the heart in every beat. Sometimes more blood is ejected from the heart with one heartbeat, and that is a higher stroke volume. And an average resting stroke volume is between 60 to 70 milliliters per beat. So the amount of blood in the heart ejected in one single contraction. We know that there's a much higher resting stroke volume seen in endurance athletes. While it's relatively easy to measure heart rate, it's more challenging to measure stroke volume. To measure stroke volume, an ultrasound of the heart needs to be taken. So what we see here is an image of an ultrasound, and I'm going to show you what it looks like for an ultrasound technician. So here you can see the two ventricles and the two atria, and the valves between the atria and the ventricle. What an ultrasound technician would be able to do is measure the volume of blood leaving the heart via the aorta. So to review, the cardiac output is the total amount of blood flowing from the heart in 1 minute. And it's going to be determined by multiplying heart rate, which is the number of contractions per minute, by stroke volume, which is the blood ejected with each beat of the heart. In the next set of videos, I'm going to discuss how heart rate can change from resting values of 60 to 100 beats per minute and increase during exercise or decrease during relaxation. And in the future video, I'll also be discussing how stroke volume is regulated.